Welcome back. So today's video, I am going to share a purchase I made 6 months ago with you all. It has been a video I have tried to film, and by tried to film, this is probably the ninth shot that I've given it. It just doesn't seem that natural to sit here and talk about this for me. I don't know why, but it just doesn't feel right. Also, I've held off doing this video because COVID, and I didn't really want to seem like somebody out there publishing a video about this in this time. But it's been 6 months since I purchased it, and I thought, well, I may as well give it a go. And if I don't do it right this time, I'm scrapping it, I'm not doing it, because nine goes is just a bit much in my opinion. Anyway, so let's pray that this is the final time that I film this. Okay. All right. So September last year, I decided that I was going to make this purchase. It wasn't something that has just come lightly for me. I've wanted one of these for probably close to a decade. It's something that's literally, I think the only thing left on my wish list was to get a bracelet from Cartier. I have a ring, I have a watch, and I always wanted a bracelet. My first obsession was the love cuff, but then recently, actually, I didn't even know that they made this bracelet. I'm always the last to know these things. So when I found out that they made this bracelet in a small size, that was it. I was buying it. So from September, I literally moved heaven and earth to make this happen. I sold a bunch of stuff. I saved everything that I could, and my hard work paid off when I had this sitting under my tree at Christmas, which was pretty exciting. So I'll talk to you about the bracelet. Okay, this isn't the first time I'm unboxing it. I just put it in here for the video. So like anything that you buy from Cartier, comes with the box, comes with bunch of paperwork. So you've got your receipt, you've got your certificate of authenticity. I'll just cover that up. There you go, in the wee envelope. And because I had this under the Christmas tree for my Christmas present, it was a joint Christmas present between my savings account, family, my husband. Oh, that's my ring box. I had it wrapped as well with the wax seals, which was quite special, and I'm a geek. I kept the wax seals. So this is the box it comes in, and the bracelet that I got is the Justin Clou bracelet. I hope that's how you say it. Anyway, it is the nail bracelet in the small without the diamonds. So that's the bracelet. As you can see, it's beautiful, it's gold, it's bendy, and I've put it wrong around the wrong way. Try that again. There we go. So this is how you put it on, like that and like that. Excuse my weird tan lines. So as I mentioned before, this is something I've wanted for a long time. When I went in to purchase this bracelet, we had a lovely sales assistant help us. I took my husband in just to share in the experience with him. When I went in with the intention of buying this bracelet. Nothing else but the bracelet. I was walking out with this bracelet. However, I did try on the love cuff when I was in there, and I fell back in love with the love cuff. And my husband did point out to me that the love cuff was a better buy just because it was more substantial than this bracelet. I went in to buy the bracelet, so I left with the bracelet, but it left me second guessing my decision on this bracelet, because the difference in price between the two is about $2,000. And the love cuff is solid, where this isn't a solid bracelet because it has that bending mechanism in it. And you think of the difference in price and you think to yourself, maybe that is a very, very valid point. That said, even though it did reignite my love for that particular bracelet, I love the look of this bracelet because the style is a little bit more me. If I was to have my time again with this, I would have probably liked to sit on this for about a month or two longer, just because I think I would have liked to have thought the purchase out for a little bit more time after trying on both bracelets. This bracelet, as gorgeous as it is, you do have to be really careful with it. Now, by careful, I mean the first time that it, I'll show you, if it flips around the other way, the first time this happened, I freaked out and thought that I had broken it. It does, from time to time, with being caught on things, flip over. So you have to be careful. So basically you have to be careful putting on tops and jumpers, making sure that it doesn't get caught in your scarf or anything that you're taking off. You have to be careful carrying shopping bags, because the first time it flipped over like that, I literally froze because I thought I'd broken my bracelet, even though obviously I hadn't. But it's something that you do have to be really careful of. That said, since the day I've worn this, I have literally worn it every day. I think there was like maybe a week that I didn't wear it. So right now I've got the cost per wear down to around $25. So cost per wear, absolutely worth the money, because I've gotten it to a point where by the end of the year it's going to be, gosh, probably, let's have a look. Yeah, $13 by Christmas this year. So by the end of the year, it's going to be down to $13 cost per wear. So as far as I'm concerned in relation to that, I'm happy with it. I've worn it every day. I love the style. I like the fact that it is a bit petite. You just need to be careful if you do buy this that you're not, that you just need to be careful with it. That's all. Like you should be with any kind of piece of fine jewelry. So yeah, I guess that's my honest opinion. That said, there's absolutely no regrets in buying it, because I 100% love it. It's like one of my favorite pieces of jewelry so far. So in relation to wish list, obviously I've mentioned that I love the love cuff, absolutely, but oh my gosh, have you seen the Panthre bracelet? It is stunning. So that's the next thing that I'm basically saving money for now, is the Panthre bracelet. I went into the boutique in Sydney and tried it on. I'll pop a photo of it here. I absolutely love it. It is stunning. It has beautiful green stone eyes and a black onyx nose, and it's just gorgeous. The only thing with this one, it does have the same mechanism as this. That said, it's really gorgeous. So that one is literally what I'm moving heaven and earth right now as we speak to make my second bracelet purchase, hopefully within the next 12 months. Anyway, so that's it for me today. I hope you liked this video. Let me know if you would like me to do a review on my other two Cartier pieces. I have a love ring and also a vintage tank watch. I'm more than happy to do videos on them. If that's something you'd like to see, let me know in the comments. Also, do you have things on your Cartier wish list? Pop them down below. Would love to see what you've got in your collection, or what you've got in your wish list. Just let me know. Love to have a chat with you about it. Okay, I will see you again next time. Bye.